Hey guys, Ryan back here at Ground Control along with Brian. Still working our counters to full guard attacks. Now we're moving on to the triangle choke. So I'm gonna be in Brian's guard. And he's locking up the triangle. Now, for me, I kind of look at what counter I do from the triangle based on what step Brian is in as far as setting. I know that the next step Brian's gonna have from here is moving my arm across the center line and then trying to set his triangle in order to get the finish. So if this is the stage that I'm in, I'm gonna go towards my first line of defense. So the first thing I try to do is, knowing he wants to get my arm across, I try to prevent. So I'm gonna keep my elbow glued towards his hip. The next thing I do is I'm gonna take my free hand and I establish a gable grip right at the hip. Now, I wanna make sure my posture is underneath of me. So we'll show from this angle real quick. You see there's like a slight slant in my back. I wanna bring my knees in, my hips come up, and now I'm looking to posture to keep my head away. And the higher I can keep my head, the tougher it's gonna be for him to finish. I'm gonna put a lot of tension onto his legs when we maintain good posture. So the next thing that I try to do is, as I'm hugging at the hip, I'm gonna do small little rotations until my elbow catches the outside of his thigh and we're able to break that guard. Now there's a couple of different things we can do from this point. I can take my outside hand, swim it back in, and now I'm out of the triangle. This is a prevention. I look at this as a prevention rather than a counter, meaning I've stopped him from being able to hit the technique, but I'm not really in a more advantageous position. The other thing that we can do from this point, well, if I can pull one hand in pretty easily, I can take the other arm out. So I'm gonna go ahead and continue to bring my elbow out, dropping my hand, so his knees load up onto my shoulders, and now I establish my gable grip right by his belt knot. From here, I'm gonna do a slight sweep of the mat, so I'm gonna scoop his hips. I'm gonna pick a side that I want to pass towards, and now the side that I'm gonna pass towards, the opposite arm is gonna open his gi, and I'm gonna slide my hand down and establish my grip with a thumb entry. So I'm feeding the lapel towards my opposite side hand. I come up towards my toes, driving his hips over his head. And now my hand that was on the same side as the lapel that I isolated is gonna come back right to his hip, right by his gun holster. From here, I'm gonna start taking steps towards his head, pulling onto the hip, looking over my shoulder and sprawling my hip down towards the mat. This passes his guard. And now I'm looking to get my knees in place. Once my knees are in place, we're coming underneath the head, and then I'm finally gonna remove the hand from his hip into a good side control position. The end part of this is gonna be very similar to the stack pass that we do in another video. So as Brian puts me through to the triangle, I keep my elbow tight and I make sure that I posture up. Once I have good posture, I'm gonna do a rotation towards the arm that's in the triangle. With little bumps, once I feel it break, my elbow comes back and my hands grip right at his belt. Now, I don't wanna just drive straight towards the stack from here. I wanna pull his shoulders towards me. And now I'm gonna look to put a lot of weight onto his shoulders. I look to establish a lapel grip. My thumb enters, the other hand feeds. And now, once I have good connection, my arm comes back right to the hip, right where his gun holster would be. Now, on my toes, taking steps all the way over. I'm not flat on my feet. That's not driving any weight. I'm extending out almost like a plank position. And then I continue to walk towards his head. I'm gonna look over the shoulder by his legs, pulling his hips across, and now I put my knees in place. Once my knees are in place, I release the lapel, coming underneath, and finally releasing his hip and establishing a good side control position. That's a triangle defense from full guard.